Jag heter Johan och jag är från Stockholm och jag talar svenska.
Hej allihopa! Hi everyone and welcome to another episode of Say It in Swedish, sayinswedish.com, your best resource for learning Swedish online. Haha, self-promo, hashtag. If you're one of those people who really loves Sweden and you're expecting a baby, maybe you want to call your baby something that Swedes call their babies too, and then you're in for a treat, because we are going through the 10 most popular girls' names and the 10 most popular boys' names. And since we have 20 names to cover, I'm allowing myself to use my phone for notes today. And let's begin with the girls' names, shall we? And the first one is actually also the name, the second name of my daughter, and it's Alice. And Alice is a French short form for the German Adelheid. I know, that's a mouthful. Actually, one of my guinea pigs were called Adelheid. But the short form for that in French is Alice, I think, with a French accent. But in Swedish, it's Alice. And it's a very beautiful name, I think. Then we have Maya, which is also a very nice, short, beautiful name. Most of these are actually very short names. And Maya is a name from the Greek mythology, but nevertheless a very nice name. And then we have Lily, which is from English, Lily, and that's really short for Elizabeth. Fourth name is Ella, which is another Greek name because it's short for Helena, which is a Greek. Then we have Vilma, which is also a very nice name, and it's short for Wilhelmina. Most of these are short names, but not only like short names, they are shortened versions of other names. So Vilma is short for Wilhelmina, which is the feminine version of the German Wilhelm. Maybe you can hear a few similarities to William there, because there are. And then we have Ebba, which is short for the German name Eberhard. Also a mouthful, god damn. Then we have Olivia, which is English for Olivia, which is the feminine form for Oliver, and so on. And I think there was different suggestions for origin, so I'm not gonna cover that. Then we have our first real Norse name, which is Astrid. And I actually had an Astrid in my class back in the day, and that was pretty exotic back then, because it's a grandma's name, basically. And actually, all of these are pretty much like names that were popular 100 years ago or something. It's nice that they're coming back now, I think. And the name Astrid, or the Norse, or the Old Norse equivalent, Asfridr, there you can really hear the compound better, comes from the word os, which in modern Swedish means cadaver, but in Old Norse, it's the name for the gods, the old gods. By the old gods and the new. Yes, and the next part, Frid, or Fridr, means beautiful. In modern Swedish, it means peace, but back then it meant beautiful. So like, beautiful as a goddess or something, that's the name. Or like, you're really, really, a really beautiful person is called Astrid, basically, if you look at the origin. Then we have Alma, which is also, if you know Emil I Lönneberga, Alma Svensson is the name of his mother, yes. And Alma comes from Spanish for soul, I think, or Latin for mild, yeah. And even though it's not a Nordic name, it's very old, like, we have had it in Swedish for hundreds and hundreds of years. And lastly on the list, the 10th Swedish girl's name here is Elsa, which is apparently short for Elsaby, which is comes like short or a nickname for Elizabeth again. And we'll have this one since the 1400s. So this one is also pretty old. So there you have it, the 10 most popular girls' names of 2018. Very nice, short and beautiful names. And we have the same trend here, actually. If you look at the boys' names, they are also, most of them, are very short. Let's begin with the first one, which is William. And yes, that's from English William, which is in from the German Wilhelm, as I said before. Then we have Liam, which is actually the Irish version of William. Who would have thought? That's cool though. That's kind of funny that the both, like, the first and the second most popular names, those are like, they have the same origin. So that's cool. Then we have Noah, which is from Hebrew. You all know the, you know the guy from the Bible. Then we have the fourth name, which is Lucas, which is a Greek name. And then we have Oliver, which is English. And it's cool that we have Olivia, the feminine version of that, in the list for girls. And we also have Oliver in the list for boys. So both versions. And same goes for Wilhelmina, or Vilma was the name we had. And we have William here in the list, or William. Then we have Oscar, which is actually, we had two kings called Oscar in the 1800s. And yeah, which is Old Irish. That's pretty cool. It's a very uncommon origin of names, I think, at least. And it probably is a Norse name, probably from Icelandic. Asgeir. So you have As there again, the gods, like in Astrid, Asfridr, and here you have Asgeir or something. I don't know the pronunciation rules of Old Norse or Old Icelandic, but apparently it means God spear. And then we have Elias, which also a very, I think this name has been pretty common for a few years now. A lot of boys are called Elias for some reason. It's Hebrew. And then we have Hugo. Hugo. For some reason, I imagine someone with very, very big ears. I don't know why. But I associate the name with that for some stupid reason. And it's short for Hubert, which is a German name. Then we have Adam, which is Hebrew. And lastly, we have Alexander, which is Greek. All right. Wow. 20 nice, very nice and short baby names. They were all pretty nice, actually, I think. So, if you're expecting a baby, consider one of these names. They are trendy now, but if you don't want to be trendy, don't use these names. If you want to learn Swedish, you know what to do. SayInSwedish.com, audio lessons, vocabulary lists, other nice resources. And if you want to talk to me and other people, we have a Discord server, we have a Reddit community, and we have a Facebook group. And if you are expecting a baby that you are naming after this list, let me know. Send me a picture of your baby. Would be cool. And we will see each other in the next video. Okay, take care. Hejdå!